Okay, as you know, chemical compounds and their formulas come in a huge variety. There are almost an unlimited number of them. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to calculate the molar mass for various chemical compounds using their formulas. Now let's go through really quickly what molar mass is. Molar mass is simply the mass of one mole, just like it says, molar mass, mass of one mole. All right, a mole, of course, is a number of particles. It's the metric unit that expresses the number of particles that you have. One mole is equal to 6.02 times 10 to the 23 particles, 23rd particles. Of course, that's a huge number, almost unimaginable, but it is just what it is. It's one mole, it's 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. You know a dozen is 12, and now you know that one mole is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. Okay, let's go through and just look at a couple of molar masses for actual elements before we do compounds. We have carbon and aluminum. We look at our periodic table. We have, this is the carbon block. I have the atomic number is 6. C is the symbol. Here's the name. And this number, as it says over here, is the average atomic mass, but that is also the molar mass. For aluminum, the molar mass is 26.98, and for carbon, it is 12.01. So I'm just going to write that down, and I write it down like this. I just don't write down 12.01. I put one mole is equal to 12.01 grams. And I can do the same thing for aluminum. One mole is equal to 26.98 grams. Okay, I got those numbers right off my periodic table. If I want a mole of aluminum, if I want 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd atoms of aluminum, I just would have to take my balance and weigh out 26.98 grams of aluminum. Okay, now let's do some compounds. Now, they have a compound, have hydrogen, sulfur, oxygen, different numbers of each element in our chemical formula. So I think there's a process, some steps that you can do that will help you to be successful if you follow these steps. The first step, of course, is to write down what elements you have. In this case, we have hydrogen, we have sulfur, and we have oxygen. That is step one. The next step is to write down how many atoms of each element there are. Hydrogen, there's 2, so I put 2 times. Sulfur, there's 1, so I put 1 times. Oxygen, there's 4, so I put 4 times. Step two. Now for step three, I'm going to write down their molar masses. The molar mass of hydrogen, of course, is 1.01. I'm getting this right off of my periodic table. Grams, sulfur, is 32.07 grams, and oxygen is, of course, 16.00 grams. Those are the molar masses right from the periodic table. Now I'm going to multiply across, and then I'm going to add them up. So 2 times 1.01 is, of course, 2.02, and I'm going to put a gram there. This is 1 times 32, so I'm just going to write down 32.07 grams, and 4 oxygens gives me 64.00 grams. So I'm going to just do that. I'm going to add them up, and I end up with the molar mass of sulfuric acid is 98.09 grams, and I'm going to write that down like this. One mole is equal to 98.09 grams. That is the molar mass for sulfuric acid. All right, so we followed the steps. Of course, the last step was to write down the answer. All right, let's do another one. Okay, once again, we're just going to follow the same steps. I think if we follow those steps, we should be successful. And we, of course, here we have lead nitrate. So we have some lead, we have some nitrogen, and we have some oxygen. In this case, we have one lead, we have 2 nitrogens, and we have 6 oxygens. This 2 is outside the parentheses. It applies to everything that's inside. We have 2 nitrates. Each nitrate has 1, so we have 2 of those. And this one has each nitrate has 3 oxygens, so we have 6. I can just think of it as distributing this through 2 times 1, 2 times 3 is 6. All right? So lead has a molar mass of 207 point, my notes here, 207.02 grams. Nitrogen is 14.01 grams, and oxygen is still 16.00 grams. Now I'm going to multiply these through, which is this stays as 207, obviously. This becomes 28.02 grams, and 16 times 6 is 96 grams. And I'm going to add them all up, and I get that the molar mass of lead nitrate is 331.04 grams. And that means that my answer is that one mole of lead nitrate has a mass of 331.04 grams. Okay, that is the answer to that question. Erase that. Let's go on to the last one. We're going to do one more. As you can see, we have calcium chloride. Oops, this should be a lowercase 2, but this, excuse me, a subscript 2, but we have calcium chloride. We have two waters on it, so we call that calcium chloride dihydride. We have some calcium, we have some chlorine, we have some hydrogen, and we have some oxygen. How many of each? One, two. We have two waters. Each water has two hydrogens, so we have four. We have two waters. Each water has one oxygen, so we have two oxygens. And then we can write down the molar masses. Molar mass of calcium is 40.08 grams. Chlorine is 35.45 grams. Hydrogen is still 101 grams. And oxygen is still 16.00 grams. Okay, the next step, we're going to multiply these through. Well, it's just one calcium, so this is 40.08 grams. This is, 35 times 2 is 70.90. 4 times this is 4.04, not 4.01. And this last one, of course, 16 times 2 is simply 32.00 grams. So I add them all up, I get 147.02 grams. That means that the molar mass of calcium chloride dihydride is equal to 147.02 grams. That is the answer. Okay, so you can see I followed the steps. I wrote down the elements, I wrote down how many, I wrote down the molar masses, I multiplied across, and then I added them up, I got my answer, and then I wrote my answer down like that. Okay, I think that's pretty straightforward. Follow those steps, follow that process, and you will be successful. Okay, thank you very much. I hope that was helpful. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave them in the comment section below. Thank you.